23 years after Hong Kong returned to Chinese rule, the mainland government has moved swiftly to tighten its control over the city. Hours after a sweeping new security law was enacted, Hong Kong and Chinese dignitaries attended a ceremony marking the handover anniversary. A hoarding exhorting the new law, providing the backdrop. The chief executive, who was sidelined during the drafting of this law, said it was timely and necessary.
The enactment of the national law is regarded as the most significant development in the relationship between the central authorities and Hong Kong since its return to the motherland.
Out to test the new law, a small group of protesters who tried to march on the venue but were blocked by police. They called for an end to one-party rule. One of them said he was aware their actions could now amount to a violation of the law.
The law enforcement in Hong Kong, what they always do is they allow you to protest and make the arrest later. So today I come out and chant out end one-party dictatorship, knowing full well that probably I'll get arrested or charged.
The scope of the legislation is far-reaching. Article 38 says it can essentially target anyone, anywhere. Another stipulates that the maximum penalty for breaking the new law is a life sentence. Well, this is it, Hong Kong's new security law. The English version runs to 39 pages. It's very detailed in parts and also very vaguely worded in others. And what worries some legal experts here is that this new law could be very broadly applied, just as similar laws are on the mainland. In Beijing, senior government officials were doing their best to counter critics who say China's actions marked the end of Hong Kong's special autonomy.
The law will safeguard national sovereignty, security and development and ensure Hong Kong's enduring social order, long-term prosperity and stability.
Carrie Lam says she wants to rebuild Hong Kong's battered image, a strategy that includes hiring an international public relations agency at a cost of almost $6 million. It could be a tough sell. Adrian Brown, Al Jazeera, Hong Kong.